Hello, Magic Community on YouTube. I'm T1GlistenerElf. It's my good friend DC7. We are about to take his battle box and do a Solomon draft with it. So this huge pile has already been shuffled. And for those that don't know what a Solomon draft is, it's from, I don't know if it's the Legend of Solomon or the Parable or what. So he takes a baby. Two mothers are debating which one is, like, the baby is hers or hers. And he says, okay, we're going to split the baby in half, and you can each have a half. The mother that says, no, don't do that, just let her have it, that's the mother. So, based on that, we take a group of cards. We're going to go 8 each time. Mm-hmm. And one of us will take a look at those cards first without letting the other person... I guess it doesn't really matter. They can see, too. It'll save a little time if we see at the same time. But normally you don't. And we'll split them into two piles, fact or fiction them. You'll get to take one, I'll get the other, and then we'll switch. And it'll go, me, you, you, me, you, you, me, you, me, and then we're done. And that'll be the deck. The cards that we get will be the ones with which we construct the deck that we'll play in just a minute. So, with these 8 cards to get started... Okay. So this'll be fun. Let's see. And with this many cards each time... in a battle box. This will be tricky to do quickly, and I apologize for that in advance. Necrotic Sliver, Dromar's Charm, Thunderscape Battle Mage, Murderous Cut, Vampire Interloper, Think Twice, Urborg Emissary. Okay. So let's see. How about... And it's hard to try to quickly explain the logic in doing this, but a lot of it is I'm trying to make sure that I distribute the colors pretty evenly, while also making sure that there's not too much of one archetype. So for example here, control, control, mid-range aggro. This one plays pretty aggro, this one is tempo, little in the middle, little in the middle. So I'm trying to keep that as even as I can. And also try not to give too much versatility. Whatever I give him, I need to make sure they're even enough that I get enough value out of it this way. So, my friend, here are your piles. You have...
I want this pile.
You want that pile? Okay, that was quick.
I just want Murderous Cut.
Okay, that was easy. I want Think Twice, so we're good on that, actually. Interloper, Battle Mage, Dromar's Command, and Think Twice. So we each kind of got what we wanted.
Let's have them over here so they can see a little bit.
And I'll tier them by like which stack that is, I suppose. We'll do it that way. That's fine. That'll work. Your turn, my friend. 8 cards. Divide them however you'd like. And there are a number of different strategies for how to do this. One is to not do what I just did and give an even color breakdown. You could make sure that they get certain colors so that you can then later on try to bite them by giving them fewer colors in a pile you know they need. Not allowed talking for this part, and I apologize. Give me just a minute. These are the piles?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so Seagate Oracle, Chromanticore, Thornscape Familiar, Merfolk Looter, or Wrecking Ball, Nest Invader, Nightscape Battle Mage, Woolly Thakatar. So except for you, all of these deal with blue, and none of you have quite... I guess 3 reds, actually, when we count the Battle Mage's ability. So I certainly sense a theme going on here. I already have some card draw off of Think Twice... and I don't think Dromar's Command... No, you don't draw a card. Thunderscape Battle Mage also doesn't draw you a card. That's discard, of course. this one just looks like a whole heck of a lot of value. And also, since we're playing a battle box, Chromanticore is really good, because we'll definitely each have all of our colors. So given that, I think that I'll actually take this pile. Alright? And now, my friend, you get to do it again for what would be pack two.
Chromanticore is definitely the best card there, I think.
Yeah. It's hard to turn that down.
It's hard to deal with. Kills you out of nowhere because it has haste.
Mm. It has everything. It has first strike, flying, vigilance, trample, lifelink.
I mean, it doesn't have haste, but it, you know, it can be
it
on a creature.
It feels like haste.
That...
Yeah, I know what you mean. You're right. You're right.
Okay, we got some juicy ones here.
Oh boy.
So they don't have to be even, right?
They don't have to be 4 and 4. If you think that one pile is way more powerful than another, you can do that.
But that's also interesting. Are we using every card what we draft?
No, you can select... Well, oh, we can do that. Since it's Battle Box, we can.
I think we should do a 40-card deck.
Okay.
Since if I put these two by themselves, you'll take those because they thin your deck and make your card quality overall higher.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'm in agreement with that. And normally you would just do 40-card decks. Since this is a Battle Box, I didn't know if that changed it any.
I'll do it like that.
Okay. So, to me, it seems clear, Cloud Goat Ranger and Deadbridge Chant are both excellent, excellent cards. In this pile, Mind Control is really good. Asmira Holy Avenger is fine, certainly. She doesn't really save you from Wraths, though, and not that there are that many Wraths in here, but it makes combat a little bit harder for your opponent. Mogus Marauder. X target creatures gain Intimidate and Haste, where it's devoted black. And lo and behold, he gives me the Lilith Troll and the Liliana Spectre.
Certainly a nice package.
Yeah. These are powerful cards. Cloud Goat Ranger is, I guess, Deadbridge Chant, that's, if the game is going really long, that's a lot of value. And it depends on what I'm trying to do here. I think I'll actually take the 5.
Okay.
And you can have your Ranger. You can have Mr. Ranger, sir. Now, I will be doing it twice in a row. How's about 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Savor the moment. Hey!
New Pone's card player,
Sting Scourger. Crackling Counterpart, Harmsway, Necrogen Scudder, Bloodbraid Elf, Fleshbag Marauder. So, obvious card is obvious. Oh, boy. Oh, boy. Let's see. I guess I could put all the... Man, this is tough.
Yeah, splitting is really hard.
For something like this, absolutely.
Kind of like Fact or Fiction. Splitting is the hard part, but choosing is usually easier.
Let's see. In Battle Box, actually, Savor the Moment is a control card, weirdly enough, because it gets you up a land. It's a ramp spell. Hard as that may be to believe. Yeah, one of these piles looks significantly better than the other. Hmm. This is tricky, but if I do this, I'm giving you more to work with in colors you already seem to be in. All right. Tell me, my friend, do you want to help yourself or do you want to hurt me?
I want these cards.
Yep. Okay.
I don't really want to give you Bone Splitter because you've got so many black aggro cards.
Yeah.
But Bloodbraid Elf. I think Harm's Way is really good too.
It is, and no doubt. So then 5, 6, 7, 8. We'll do it again. Alright. Master Admirer, Sophie Eric's daughter, Seeker of the Way, Loyal Cathar. Poor guy. Misdirection. Elephant Guide, Repeal, Jungle Barrier.
That is an interesting pile.
Yeah. This is, everything is Bant. Everything is Bant in here. Well, okay. In that case, this is odd. This is definitely not done yet, don't worry. We're not there yet. I definitely want to keep a few of you away from each other. And that's easy.
Those are piles?
Yep, these are the piles. Guide, Cathar, Misdirection, Sophie versus Seeker, Repeal, Jungle Barrier, Jungle Boogie, and Masked Admirers.
I really wish that you'd put Elephant Guide and Seeker in the way. Yeah. Seeker in the way in the same pile, but it's probably pretty good that you didn't.
There's a reason I didn't do that.
And I'll take these.
Yep, you get the card draw. I was actually trying not to take Misdirection. I do not like that card in this.
Yeah, I don't have any other blue cards already, so.
And then, yeah, it's your turn to do it a couple times.
Okay.
Gigantomancer.
Oops. That's not correct.
Yeah, it happens.
Here, can you shuffle that for me?
Sure. While you do your thing. So, Gigantomancer, Cartel Aristocrat, Merciless Eviction, Otherworldly Journey, Frostburn Weird, Ravenous Rats, Utopia, Urban Evolution, and Notion Thief. It's amazing to me that we've only come across... Actually, the one counter spell so far isn't even a real counter spell.
Yeah, I'll do it like that. These two piles.
Oh. Oh, boy. We'll take this one. Take the bottom pile, you get the Merciless Eviction, my friend. Oh. That was very tempting. Just that card in and of itself. Mm-hmm. So, since that was number 6, that means you go again. We're halfway there.
Hmm.
Demirgilke, Corpse Jack, Menace, Carrion Feeder, Aven Rift Watcher, Steward of Valoran, Phantasmal Bears, Morcrit Banshee, and Rapid Hybridization. Oh yeah.
Okay, those two.
You know, I had my answer immediately, and you had to go and do that. Not nice to have the Carrion Feeder and the Corpse Check Menace in different piles. Oh well. Take these. All right. My turn again. 1, 2, 3, 4,
so
five,
after
six.
This, I go and then it's done. You do twice and then I do once.
It's supposed to be about the equivalent of 6 packs, so I'll go, then I'll go. Wait a minute. Yeah, we would do this a total of 12 times. Okay. So we still have 5 more to go. 2, 5, 6, 7, 8. Here we are.
Oh, that makes sense. Yeah, it should end on you. Yeah.
The Omegas, Spike Feeder, Cytoplasm Rootkin, Naya Charm. Hey, buddy. World Queller, ooh, Wrathy Trapper, Illuminate, Deputive Equivals.
Illuminate.
Illuminati confirmed. Okay. Deals X damage to that creature's controller, and then you draw X cards. Well, geez. That seems good. That seems real good. How about... I like putting... I don't think that I like putting you guys together. Three damage to target creature, return grave to hand, card and grave. Tap all creatures. Not done quite yet, but think about this a moment more. Alright, my friend.
These two piles, eh?
These indeed. Sorry.
I really want the trapper. But I don't know if I can let you have Cytoplasm Rootkin and Corpse Shack Menace. Then again, Spike Feeder and Corpse Shack Menace. It's pretty good.
Yeah.
I'll take the, I guess I'll take the two removal spells. Why not? It's pretty good rule of thumb.
Alright. And then I'll go again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Is this your first time Solomon drafting?
Yeah. I've drafted where you draft face down 5 cards.
Oh.
Like, one of them, like, I would look at them, put them in 2 different piles, and then you pick which pile you want without seeing what they are.
I wonder what this would be like if there wasn't a choice. If it was just 4 or 4, would I couldn't rearrange them, and then you just pick from there. No, this is fine. That's a lot of removal on that side. I think these fit rather nicely into archetypes. Alright, my friend. How would you like to do this? Porcelain Legionnaire, Rectos Cackler, Dismantling Blow, Disfigure, Gurmog Angler, Sunscape Battle Mage, Memory Lapse, War Leader's Helix. Media promo. FNM promo.
Take these.
Okay. Alright, now it's your go. You do it twice, then I'll do it once, and then we'll be good.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Yeah, you do kind of see what's going on. Oh, boy. Yeah, I take this one.
Yep.
Alright. You want some more, my friend? You got it. Tribal Flames, Tribal Nameless Flames. Inversion, Kavu Climber, Unsummon, Beck Call, Prophetic wow. Bolt,
yeah.
Wake Dancer, Recoil. Holy crap, dude. So much removal here. You hear the gears turning, YouTube.
I'll do that.
There we go. All right, last one. All right, see what we get. And was this the whole battle box, by the way?
No, that's half of it.
Okay.
The other half's over there.
Planar Guide. Hey, new card. Not Vine. Hey, new card. Warped Physique. Take Possession. Sign in Blood. Kavu Titan. Splinter Twin, I'm Pester Mite, and Aether's Knife. Oh god, if there were Splinter Twin in this. Okay. Here we go.
Those two piles, eh?
Yep. The Pest, the Snipe, the Warp, and the Paladin. Or the Knot. Or the Sign, the Guide, the Titan, and the Take. I don't know. That doesn't really work.
I'll take these.
Fair enough. All right, and from that, we have our piles. We'll be back in just a moment. And there we go. So, let's see, since I did the first draft, do you want to go first?
Let's roll for it.
Alright.
And, four cards.
Oh, four cards, it's still battle box. Alright, 10. 8, alright.
I'll play.
Ta-da! There we go.
3, 4.
I will get used to that eventually.
Okay.
I'll keep.
Likewise. Let's see.
Demir Gilgit, go ahead.
Alright. Demir Gilgit, go ahead.
Yeah, we want a red. Frostburn weird.
Okay.
Go ahead.
Fair enough. Bone Splitter.
Mm-hmm.
Timber Gorge. Pass turn. Potentially taking a bunch.
Swing one.
Alright.
Necrogen Scudder.
Necrogen Scudder.
Your turn.
Yeah, that's a card. That is a card. Mm-hmm. Cards in hand is...
I've got four.
Three? I've got four. Nameless Inversion.
My turn.
Azorius Guildgate. Pass turn.
Draw.
Can't let you do that, Star Fox.
Make him a 3-2.
Yep. Oh, so in main phase. Three. Yeah, I'll take it.
Celestia Guildgate.
Mm-hmm.
Pass turn.
All right. Let's recoil that. Turn it to hand, then discard a card.
I'll discard Mask Admirers.
Alright. That makes a lot of sense. Good grief, man. Well, that could have gone better. And then after that, play a Rakdos. Play a Celestia Guildgate, and it's all yours.
Cloudgate Ranger.
Seems. Oh, I have them.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, they're over here.
Go ahead.
The Kithkin. Army of Kithkin. You may have seen better days, buddy. Maybe. Okay, I have it. Kind of. No, just a second. So we'll play a go black, green, Lotlith Troll.
Okay.
These two and a Plains. Wait. These two and take two, actually, for Porcelain Legionnaire.
Mm-hmm.
And then I will pass the turn.
Untap. Draw. I'll attack for 5 in the air.
Mm-hmm. It flies. You have me to 9.
Okay. Frostburn weird. Getting back. Master Myers.
Fair enough.
Island. Pass turn.
Not when I need you, buddy. I'll play a Seagate Oracle.
Mm-hmm.
Let's see what cards I get. Okay. I'll pass turn to you, actually. It's a big dude?
Mm-hmm.
Alright. Tell me when you're about to go attacks.
Going to attacks.
Test your might. We're going to tap down the Cloud Gut Ranger.
Okay.
Alright.
Hmm. Thank you. Avian Rift Watcher.
Alright. Couple of life.
Three time counters. And Gruul Guildgate. Pass turn.
All right. I'll play a Fleshbag Marauder. Let's each sacrifice a creature.
Okay.
I find how many flyers you have to be a little unfortunate. I guess we'll drop the Oracle. Wake Dancer. It's a 2/2 because of Morbid. It makes a 2/2 zombie.
Okay.
Would you happen to have a zombie token anywhere in there, my friend?
Oh, a zombie token. That's child's play.
Yeah.
Here you go.
Alright, thank you, thank you. Just tagging along. They're both 2/2s. Played a Rakdos Guildgate. And then... You know what? Pass the turn.
Otherworldly Journey, targeting Cloudgate Ranger.
All of the Kithkin. It gets a +1/+1 counter. We have three more Kithkin.
Untap.
Did we lose one along the way?
I sacrificed it.
That's right. Okie dokie.
Because you made me a people.
You made me do it. Sure. I thought there was a chance you might sack the Rift Watcher and gain life off it anyway.
Nah. Not with my plans.
Fair enough. It's kind of about to get terrifying.
Night Charm, tap all your creatures.
Oh my god, really? That's the mode?
That's
tap
what it all says. Your...
Oh wow. Yeah, I think that's game, isn't it? I'm at 9, so...
Yeah.
Yeah, that's lethal right there, actually.